Okay. No, no, no problem. Okay. Yeah. Have the experience here. If you hear correct, right? You know, if you hear correctly.
I don't know.
Du bist Deutsche oder was?
Here in my place, you know.
Was spricht er? Deutsch? Polen? Oh, you translate for him, please.
He says that he's not sure if this is the right place, if he's not good.
So he means this is a real master, all right?
No.
What is it then? Is it real path for you?
Because
it was the
with another school.
What?
With another path.
Yeah, who asked you to come here? Hmm? That always happens with the people who do shopping too much. Explain to him. And then you're confused. You should ask yourself whether you're sincere enough, okay? If you're really sincere and this is the path for you. If you doubt, that means you're not sincere enough. You can use microphone. You speak what?
Polish.
Polish, okay. Only when we are really sincere, then God will bring us to the most, the most suitable path for us. Tell him, there's no question about whether a master is good or not. There's only one question, whether the student is good or not. As long as we are not yet ready, as long as we are not truly, sincerely seek the high, the most high, we will encounter all kind of level of masters, but not the highest one. So the question remains with you, okay? Until you know that you really seek the most high, or you seek magical power, or you seek some curiosity, all right? Why don't you speak louder? So, is there a Polish translation? Okay, okay, then it's good. Yeah. Is it clear? You have another question? Yeah. Take your time, okay? Tell him, take his time. And check your own heart. I am sure that you are on the right path. But my surety cannot help you if it's not your surety. Yeah? If you can trust me, then I tell you 100% in God's name that you're on the best path. Okay. But if it is yourself, you must trust yourself. Okay? Trust your intuition, your wisdom, your sincerity. Then you know it is right or not. Okay. Any more question? Okay. Yes. New one?
We are not allowed touched by other people.
It's not allowed. It's not allowed. Just that you are now on the highest connection with the Most High power, okay? If you go and bow to somebody else and ask him to bless you, then you lower your status, all right? That's all. Otherwise, in daily life, people touch you, they hug you. Well, how can you do it? How can you avoid it? Understand now? Okay, yes. That's all right? So don't lower your status and beg for any blessing from anybody else except your own master.
Yes.
Capisce?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you. I'm working with massage.
It's okay.
It's okay.
You recite the holy name.
Yes.
And you have blessing for the patient also.
Okay.
And for yourself, meanwhile.
Thank you, Master.
Yes.
Kinesiologia. Sabade.
Is there any translation?
Yes, here. She asked if she can work with the patient.
Of course not, why not? Like massage, right?
Oh, yeah, with the massage. Yeah.
What is
it?
Spiritual healing?
Chi? Is she touching the patient? It's a muscle test or something. She's checking his muscles. She's just touching.
Yes, she can.
She can do this. Do the chinana.
Of course, if as a doctor you have some time to touch the patient to see whether they are reflex muscle or their pulse and heartbeat, it's okay. It's okay. Don't complicate things, all right? Your job, you do it. Otherwise, I cannot give you your living expenses for everybody if you change your job. It's okay. What I mean, touching people is that you don't go and beg people to bless you, you know? Like any kind of monk will bless you or put in here and thing like that. Put the sun and pass and thing like that here in India. You know that? Any kind of people. Don't just lower your standard, okay? Because you're now the children of God. You're accepted in the highest position in the kingdom of God. You should not come and beg for any lower level of blessing. That's all, okay? Otherwise, your job you should do, and your wife you should hug, embrace your husband, your children, and do live your ordinary life. Huh? Okay? Is that what you worry about? Huh? No problem, okay? Yes. It's good, no problem.
Please.
就可以有体验，可是我因为我是下午刚一心的，好像是，就现在还没有任何的感觉，不知道。对。听懂吗？常常叫人习惯了，来这边当学生比较不习惯，所以在这边想东想西了，习惯难改。OK，对于这些比较会神通。 比较会太多书，那要多耐心一点，过了一阵子就好了，OK？就说这个提升到智慧眼这儿，老师提升不起来，因为头脑老师。我知道，OK，我知道，就比较困难一点。不过不是说不可以的，以后会好了，OK？要多耐心一点，多放松一点。哎，当老师的时候就当老师，禅就这样子嘛。 现在啊，不是过去，不是未来。你当老师了之后，你就当老师；你来这边当学生，你就当学生。好玩啊，干嘛？每次都当老师无聊。<笑>你这样想就好了，就不会伤到自尊心，听懂吗？然后就不会那么复杂，不会。
心身心都不会那么挣扎，啊，它不挣扎的时候，就比较简单集中。嗯，OK，你了解秘法了哈。OK，刚才我那个学观音法门的时候，说是先观音，啊不，对，观光先观光，观光完了以后再观音。对，那么就是说观音，不，观光和观音这个中间可以间隔几个小时吗？
也可以啦，当然你可以单独观光，然后单独观音，不过因为我们观音都不念那个五趣啊，五个神称的名字啊，五大号，所以你先把他那个五的名字哈，先念一回，要集中精神一下，要保护自己的时长，不给那个外灵啊什么那些无聊的啊佛定的力量来干扰，然后你就观音这样比较更好。 OK，就这样子，并非说应该做观音，然后马上就要做观光。哦，观光，然后就马上就观音。<笑>我看到你，我也紧张了。<笑><笑><笑>你了解了哈。哎，好，okay，谢谢师父。嘿，那个五佛号哈，我是五圣号哈，可以帮忙我们习经，我们四教委的那种佛定的那种影响，而且给我们集中比较快。
所以你要做观音，先念五佛号，然后五声号，然后这样子声音更大，更专心。嗯，OK，大概十分钟、二十分钟这样我就可以。请问师傅，我的工作啊，涉及到有时候涉及到使用一些中成药。嗯，中成药有些中成药里面有动物成分。
懂。我可不可以用来给病人？可以。 有问心的人是可以给，因为你不给他们告你啊。<笑>他说你怎么这个药不给我呢？你懂吗？你是药房或是中医师什么啊？你不给他们告你啊？你做你责任就好了。这个不是你要杀生为了自己赚钱，或是为了自己满足自己的口味上那种吃啊，或是自己喝，懂不懂？就是因为众生要求嘛。
他们就这样子没办法，OK？是不是我们自己不吃就好？
这样不吃，也不要给同修吃。嗯，你就建立另外一个，你也可以建立你的病人啊。嗯，说有另外一种没有动物的成分的，哎，也很好。如果你要的话，就减少杀生之业，那我就给你。比方说这样子，他不要你就给另外 ，OK？好的。哎，不客气。嗯，
谢谢师傅。
<笑>啊，只有音而已呀。
啊？
也没有看到光呀。
有声音哈，OK，总比没有好了。你最少盲目，不过没有耳聋了。继续集中一点，OK？集中一点。你做什么工作？
啊，现在我是待业，是读书啊，还没有做。
啊，以前是做餐馆的，现在没有做了。啊，大概比较不大专心了，OK？所以我才用两个方法都给你们了。平常人家都叫观光而已啊。 关到你很起重，你就才能够听到那个声音啊，懂不懂？不过因为这边是什么都帮你们忙啊，
对，
不集中也替你们集中啊，所以声音也听到一点了，懂了没有？
所以我才能够成就你们，不然的话等你们专心到听到声音的话，
哎呀，都累是修了。
所以我不明白嘛，所以那个本草是因为我这个是不够了，增加都是一样。
啊哈，同样。
没关系，
还可以了。我看你不错了，不是不诚心了，就是比较忙了一点，头脑比较忙了，那些学校的东西。那也还有一点问题呢，我是个人的问题啊，不是我学什么东西了都很慢，不是为什么缘故，还是自己有做东西很慢，反应很慢。
对。
那你要去练武功啊。 人家打的时候就反应很快了，<笑>没关系啦，天地生下来这样就这样嘛。嗯，有一些人他的心灵比较发达了，比较常跟那个世界的工作比较接触，所以反应比较快。啊，你大概以前都当和尚了，没做什么，每天都这样子<笑>念咒，所以比较不大清楚。OK， 没关系啦。 去哪里那么快嘛？反正早晚我们还是要走啊，快也是这样子，慢也是这样子，能够赚钱够用就好了。OK，
谢谢师傅。
嗯，不客气。嗯。 不用骑吗？
在观光的时候，就是假如说一方面要把注意力集中在智慧眼，一方面呢要念五句。假如不能同时兼得，比如说你那个集中到智慧眼就忘了念五句，集中在那个念五句就忘了放在智慧眼。那么这个时候你应该选择哪？只能一个方面的话，应该是选择哪个呢？
要练习，那五句不用那么常练啊，懂吗？你集中了，偶尔念一句啊，懂吗？几分钟念一句有什么关系？The less you meditate, the more questions. The more you meditate, the less questions. That is my experience, as well as everybody else's experience. Sometimes, just because the thing we know before, you know?Like the thing we know today at the initiation are different. So our mind, the brain, the computer, don't like to accept. Saying, well, I hear different, I know different. Today you say different thing. How come? So that's why we have often the problem. But later, no more. Later, no more. Where is Valerie? Is he there? No? Valerie?When she first initiated, this is what she told me. Yeah, if I'm incorrect, anyway, you correct me, okay? She told me that before she was bad. I don't know how bad she was. What she means is she has problem and struggle and with many kind. You know, we human beings do all have like, inside struggle and fighting with ourselves inside. And then also temper, yeah.But the more she meditates more and more and more, with the group meditation especially, and now she feels good. She knows she has progress. So if the new people, just take it easy, all right? Meditate more, and then you will know everything. You don't have to ask me anymore. Mostly when you see me, you just smile. Or just we eat together or drink coffee together. We don't come...for question and discussion anymore, but we come just to enjoy each other's presence. Mostly after sometimes it become like that. It's not that all the question will be written on the blackboard for you and all the answer is there, but just that you just know. You just inside, you know? There's intuition and that you feel very satisfied, very happy, that you have no need to know even if the whole worldopen before you, you don't feel curious. It's okay if you don't know. That is the time when you know. That's why the ancient saints, they say, the one who knows likes the one who are ignorant. The one who knows do not speak, right? Do not discuss, do not argue. The one who argues is the one who doesn't know.Now we are still stuck with all kind of names and form and, you know, so we really have problem. But later on, everything will be clear. Otherwise, I would be the one who sit alone here and all the disciples would be running around somewhere else already. You know what I mean? Not that 10 years they still stick around and happier and more convinced each day.You know, that is a proof. It's not that I give you anything. I don't give you money, I don't give you any help. Of course, some, one or two, when you're really in trouble, then we help. Just like we help anybody else outside in this world who are the children of God. But that is not that I buy you with my money or with anything at all. You know what I mean? Yeah? Okay. So the more you meditate, the more you'll be sure of your path,of yourself, and the more happy you become. And then no more question, really. After a few months, you already have very less question. Even if you ask me question, you already know. Sometimes you just want to catch my attention. Yeah, that's for sure. Mostly the Chinese, yeah. They already know, but they just want to ask so that I look at them. Oh yeah, Mr. X or Mrs. E is there, thing like that. But they know.You get what I mean, yeah? Okay. So I think you just meditate for a while. Now you have too much brain here at the moment. So now I think I let loose the energy, get out, eat something, all right? And digest the power that you assimilate today. And then I see you in the evening. Is it okay? Originally, I changed. I thought, you know, first you meditate together, and then in the evening you get initiation. But then many people already expect, you know, and give me pressure inside. So I thought, okay, never mind, never mind. I let it be, all right? And you are not the only one that feel a little bit restless and a little bit agitated. And me also, every time before retreat or before initiation and after initiation, it tells you something to the new initiate. I don't know what initiation really means to you, but it means a lot to me. It's not that you sit there, listen to instruction, and you still struggling inside whether I'm worth it for you to accept as your teacher of this initiation. It's worth it for you, worthy for you to accept. It's not like that. It's one in a million years time chance. I don't know how much it means to you, but you should know. You should know how much I have to do before and after your initiation. It's not that you sit there on your pretty ass and then still wondering whether you should stay with me or you should go. You stay, you go, it's your problem. It's your right, your choice. I have no intention to bind you or to keep you or to do anything to you physically, mentally, psychically, at all. I just stand by as a very unconditional friend. Whenever you need me, you come. Should you decide to go, you go. That is all the initiation means to you. It's like you go shopping because your mind is so bad, cannot recognize what is the difference between true diamond and glass. Therefore, you struggle. Therefore, you ask so many sharp questions. But you don't know what it means. You really don't. At least the time you die, you will know. You will know what initiation means to you. At that time, no one is around you. No one can accompany you. No money can buy your power. No position can protect you from hellfire. At that time, the Master is the only one that comes to you. Then you will know. Okay? So good appetite. Whatever you do, you should do it wholeheartedly. Then you get the wholesome result. Otherwise, you get nothing. Understand? Even during initiation, if you just sit there and think of your past master, your past Buddha, or your past whatever, then you get nothing here. And then you ask me why you don't have. And then you wonder why you come here, wonder if this is right or wrong for you. You will continue wonder all your life. If you do things the way you do, and no one can ever answer you enough, your time is very valuable, as well as mine. Yeah? If your time is not available, my time is. I don't have time to run around on bus and airplane for fun. Just to come for you so that you just see me whenever you want and then hang around and then go spaziergang and then do anything you want. And then come and complain that you get nothing. And you don't know why you come here, that why you sit here and why you do this and then and others. You expect me to do everything for you. And then you don't do anything. Even just to come here and sit. We organize everything for you. Not that you have to organize. Not even. You do nothing. Nothing to do. Cooking people also cook for you. And then you don't even do that little bit of responsibility. So what do you think? Huh? What do you think? You think that's going to be okay? You think you will get God's blessing in all this way? And then you think you have everything. Then I have to do everything. And you still criticize. I don't mean all of you. I know because of some of you are very sincere, very honest to see me. That's why I am here. Do you think I'm stupid? I spend my money, my time to come here just to scold people, to get angry? Huh? Do I look crazy to you? Do I look crazy? Huh? Do I look like nobody wants me, or I have nothing to do, or I have no hobby, or I'm really a hopeless, helpless person that have to come here and then find you and then scold you for fun? Ah. So before you ask me any question, before you criticize me, before you tell me that your meditation doesn't bear fruit, you better criticize yourself. Check up with your own heart. Understand? See what's garbage inside. Otherwise, I have headache. And you will never get anything. In the old time, if you want to find a master, you know what to do or not? Any teacher, don't say master, teacher. Huh? Even now, if you go to the college, you still have to pay. If you don't pay, then your parents pay, you know? If they don't pay directly, they pay tax, you understand? To the government, and then the government pay for the teacher. And you have to go there and enroll your name and pass exam and all that. Take a lot of time and trouble. And here, I give everything to you, free of charge, out of my own expense. Not even one glass of water you invite me, and you criticize immediately. Ask all kind of garbage. Not even a little manner you have. That's why the Chinese, I throw him out. I tell him the kindergarten politeness, the most basic, he doesn't understand. So how can he attend the class here? The Chinese people have a better culture. They know how to treat the elder, the teacher. Understand? Before, if you want to go and see a teacher, any teacher, to teach you ABC even, you have to come with the best clothes, with the best manner, accompanied by your parents. Come there and bow to the teacher. Give him some gift or tea, the best tea that you can afford, or some food, some kind of delicacy, and then an envelope inside with some money. Not that the teacher asks you a lot. This is just a courtesy, you understand? So that the teacher will accept you and then teach you the best of his ability. It's not like this that you come and accept a teacher. And still sit there and talk nonsense. Talking like you know them more than everybody else. Am I a beggar to come here and beg you something? You make yourself cheap, you understand? The way you make your teacher cheap, you are cheap. You're uneducated. You hurt me. Seeing such a people as my disciple. If you know too many things, so many things, why do you have to come here and bother me, waste my time? If you know something else better, why don't you go there? Who tell you to come here? Not I. I don't even know you. I put down everything, spend all my time, my energy, my money as well, to serve you. What is the use? You tell me. What shall I do? You tell me I don't come to see you. You tell me I don't teach you. You tell me I don't spend time with you. What shall I do? Only 3 days I'm here, and you spend until the last minute you come. I wanted to give you initiation in the morning. I cannot do it because none of you here. Most of you came in the last minute and then leave at the first minute. How much time can I offer? I offer all my time. But my time must be according to your time. See that even. And then even just a little time in between, you stay outside and talk and drink coffee or do something else or play with the children a game. You don't appreciate my time. You don't appreciate my effort. Why should I come? Why should I do anything for you? So now you understand? Yes? You keep asking me, Master, why don't you come to us? Why don't you stay longer? What shall I do here? I sit here alone? I talk to myself? It's not the first time, and it's not the only time this thing happened like this. I'm always, like, always people like this. They're always somebody. Of course, I have all the patience in the world, but then, does it help you to sell myself so cheap? Does it even help you that I humble myself, that I act, I work according to your request and your time, not my time even? Does it even help you? If it does, I'm willing. But you see, it doesn't always help. If I can kill myself right now, that you understand, and that it helps you, I would do it. Just I see nothing helps you. It's so hard, like stone. I'm sorry for the one who understand already and the one who already are very developed. But I just have to tell some other people. You understand? I'm sorry if it doesn't concern you, but you must understand my position. If I don't tell them, they will never understand. If I always treat them nicely, humbly, they will treat upon my good teaching and then throw it out the window. Do you understand? And nothing good for them at all. Nothing good at all for them. Not that I'm humble, I spend my time, I accompany them, and then they know. To some people, the more I humble myself, the more arrogant they become. They think I need something from them. It's a funny situation. It's like you take a beggar, the poor, cold beggar inside your house, and then give him food and shelter, and you don't ask where he come from, and you know he has nothing, and he has no house. You know perfectly. But the beggar, on the contrary, doubt your sincerity. Wonder if the owner of the rich house wants something from him. Perhaps want to take his rag, his torn out clothes and things like that. It's a very funny situation. I already accommodate everybody. The retreat you wanted it, huh? It's not I who wanted this. I really don't like to go here. Hamburg doesn't appeal to me. But since you chose the place, okay, anywhere you want, I come with you. I have to travel too, not you. I have to prepare a lot of things for you. I have to read books late until deep in the night in order to see whether anything that I don't know that is occurring in this world at the moment, so that I talk according to your knowledge, according to what you know at the moment, so that I can break your illusion. Okay, I can help you to understand. I sacrifice everything. I don't mind. But just a little time, just a little thing that you have to do, you don't. I apologize for the one who are diligent and very, very polite and all that. I don't mean you, okay? But since you sit here, you listen together. Maybe it's also good so that later you can explain to those who complain. Yeah? Not for you to feel bad, but for you so that you understand there are situations like this. And I always encounter this. It's not the first time. But I always forget it. And for the one who are very sincere, I always have to break my head again and then do everything again, again, and again. But sometimes there's a limit. I must tell you, if you think I'm no good, you just go. You don't stay around and then make throw dirt around in the atmosphere. Normally today is not initiation day, because initiation day is a lot of garbage. A lot of karma I have to suffer before, between, and after. So it is not a good time for people to do a retreat. But since you request it, and since I'm not very here often, I let you have initiation today. But that doesn't allow you the privilege to show off like a big shot, and then steal everybody else's time, or hang around outside while you should sit in here. Two hours is enough, no? For eating and resting and going bathroom and all that. We are on retreat, you know? It's not that you come here for holiday, then I don't say anything. It's a different holiday. It's okay. But if you really want to see me, you must be here when I'm here. Not that you stay outside and talk all kind of nonsense and your mind is running all over direction. And then when you see me, you come here. And then whatever I talk, you don't even understand. Because you have not catch up with the atmosphere yet. You still hang around outside and your mind, even when you come here, your mind is still on the topic. You know? Anything else? So come here just stealing people's space and time. So I'd rather these people stay outside. If they have so much important thing to talk about, they should stay outside and talk. We don't force anybody. You should know what you come here for, and you're obliged to continue your own program. Is that not so? It's not my program. You think if you are unrespectful to a teacher, then you're good? No. On the contrary. Understand? People look down upon you because they see you have no manner, no education. You don't know what is in this world. For example, the president of America, he's not your president, maybe, right? You might not agree with what he's doing in America, but this is his own country, yeah? People voted for him, and he became their president, and then he does what his best, yeah? What to his best knowledge is good for his country. So when you see him, you still say, Mr. President, right? You respect him, his work. Maybe his work is not as good as you expected him to be, but he does his best, you understand? And as long as he still sits in that office, you respect him as the head of the state, you understand? Otherwise, even if you sit there and talk bad about the president, people will think bad about you. There are some certain manner in this world we must observe and we must understand in order to live together in harmony. You keep asking me why I don't go out and lecture and save people of the world. Is it easy to save? Today, at the initiation, the highest God power is already here, present, and still couldn't touch them. Only hellfire can burn. You understand? So difficult, so hard is the people's heart that even they sit in God's presence, in God's power, they don't feel moved. I'm so frightened to think about it. You understand? I'm so frightened to think how hard people can be, that even the most high power couldn't touch them. That's why the world is as it is. So don't ask me why. There is war, there is disaster, there is killing. What can the hair, poor, poor hair God do? This power can shut the mountains, can dry up the ocean, can make the whole universe crumble into dust, and yet it doesn't touch some of the human's heart. It's very frightening what we have become. Then you always ask me, go here, go there, and talk to you, stay with you, or save your friends, save us family members, and do this and that and others. And if I refuse, you feel, Master, why? Why doesn't she do her job? Why doesn't she have compassion and love for mankind? Aren't they suffering enough and things like that? If I can do, I would have. If Jesus could have done, he would have done. Finished. Don't have to wait until our time. If Jesus would have saved all the world, he would have done. If Buddha could have saved all the world, doesn't have to my turn wouldn't have come. Your turn would have come. You see how difficult it is? It's because we're too proud, too arrogant. We think we know too many things. We know this sutra, we know this Bible, we know all the we learn everything by heart, and then we're so proud of our own stupid knowledge. And then we think we know everything already. So whenever somebody wants to teach us something new, we refuse. Or we try to find fault, or we try to criticize, or we try to show other people that we are fantastic, we know everything, we know better than that person. We're only harming ourselves, blocking our road to freedom, blocking the road of real knowledge. We're just taking all the advertisements for the real things and then feeling proud about it. The situation of this world is like that. So I don't know. Every time I just want to run away, every time. I don't want to even say anything or talk about anything. Even you, if you practice for some time, you still don't want to talk, right? Huh? I mean, sometimes to argue with people and that make you tired, no? It does come, huh? After some time, you don't even want to talk and discuss and argue, things like that, because you know it's useless. The way they talk and the way you understand is completely different. So, you understand my situation, huh? How much less would I like to talk or go out and let people see and things like that. But of course I do it. But it takes sometimes. I have to be recharged again and again and again in order to continue. Because some people do really take a lot. Some person take one potion is enough for 1,000. You don't know that. Some people are so hard, so burdened with their own karma, that even to give him, to lift him up a little bit, it takes all the energy that you could give to 1,000 people. Do you understand that? You know? Do you ever feel something like that? Or you see that in meditation? Okay, meditate. Turn the light off. Inside, they mention about the name, the flute, the five regions. You know, the flute, the harp, the all thing like that. And in Buddhist scripture also mention about the inside sound of the drum, of the gong, of the shell, of the thing, of the sea waves, and blah, 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 all kind of things. And in the Bible as well, it mentioned like the thunder, yeah? And the thunder, the sound of thunder, God speaks like the sound of the thunder. His sound is like the sound of many water. That means the sound of sea wave, etc., etc. And also the sound of trumpet. Yeah, like when the Bible mentioned about Saint John, when he went to the second heaven, he hear the sound of trumpet, etc., etc. But these sounds are not ordinary sound. Originally, there's no such an instrument in this world. After the people who practice well, they come to heaven, they listen to the harp and the flute and all that, the direct teaching from God, which is so melodious. And then they came back here, they tried to make the instrument, which became the musical instrument of our time. That's why sometimes you see the picture of the old time, there were angels, and then the harps in between, in both sides, you know, that represent the teaching of heaven. Originally, we don't have the drum, the gong, the harp, and piano, and all these kind of things. Only after the heavenly being comes down and teach us this inner melody, then we begin to copy of the heavenly music and try to figure out how to make the flute that resembles the inner sound. So for the purpose of teaching mankind, all these masters try to make music instruments. For the purpose of teaching people, the master of all time, they make all kind of instruments. You understand? And then now, even if we hear just some of the outer instrument, our soul also feel very comforted. Is that not so? The children, when they hear music, they stop. So now, you see, in the old time, the Muslim you saw already, huh? And the Christian, when they greet, you know, then when they pray to God and they do this, you know what it is? In the old time, it is a secret signal. Must concentrate here, okay? Repeat the five names, yeah? And do the Kuan Yin. That's a secret signal when they greet each other, so that will not be known to other people. That's why when Jesus, after he resurrected, some people doubt whether it is the Master, but when he broke the bread, you know what I mean? He does some signal, then people know it's him. That is a secret signal between the Christian in the old time. You see? Concentrate on wisdom eye, remember? Huh? Repeat the five names, but now they do it up to here. in the old time, it's here, you know? It's secret, yeah? Wisdom, five names, and Kuan Yin. So then you know we are fellow practitioners, right? In the old time, you cannot say it, you cannot wear the badge, you cannot wear my picture here, my God. You'll be killed in 1 second, right? They make barbecue out of you. Pork chop. So that's why they have to do this like this, see? The wisdom eye, five names, and the Kuan Yin. But now, slowly it come down, all come up, you know, here, there, and anywhere. And then here, and come up to here, you know. Never mind, see? So, and in Buddhism, when they greet each other, they do like this. You see what I mean? It's also a secret greeting. See, here. They do like this. See, they do like this. So this also pointing to wisdom eye, you see? And then the two, Kuan Yin method. Yes, that's how they greet each other. But now they only greet and nothing else. Just like the Christian, they only do this and nothing else happen. You know what I mean? All the Muslim, they only do this and nothing happen. But woe to you who don't do it. Then you're not a real Muslim. Not a real Christian, and not a real Buddhist. You know what I mean? Only this one will make you a Buddhist. And only this one make you a Muslim. And only this one make you a Christian. There's nothing else left behind. Same with this cloth. Now, if you go in a Sikh temple, and you don't wear anything on your head, then people will throw you out. It's supposed to be for the old time when you come in, you meditate, you know. You cover yourself so that nobody see you, especially in the public, you know. And there was also a secret recognition between each other. So the woman will wear the shawl like this, and the men will cover it in their head. So when they want to meditate, they take it down and cover themselves. Also the men supposed to wear long hair too. In case, in any case, when he meditate, all the hair will cover himself. Just like we cover with the cloth. You understand? That's why the sick people, they must grow their hair very long. And now there's the only one thing left is the hair. Think like that, you know what I mean? If you don't grow your hair long as a man, you're not a sick. Otherwise, for what reason should they wear their hair long? But now the only thing left is the shawl and the hair. Now you see what I mean? All the religion originate from the same Guanyin group. It's just they have to find a way to communicate, to identify themselves. Now we have the badge, you see the name, identification card. Because we can openly practice now in some place. In some many places, still a secret, still a secret. Yeah? So, for example, in some places in Vietnam, people wear my as I say, picture inside. And when they go to group meditation, they take it out and give it to them. Thing like that, yes? Or they wear their badge inside out, yeah? And when they come inside, okay, and then they come. For example, like that. Similarly, in the old time, very difficult to practice this kind of spiritual openly. Because it is the power of God. It's a real power. If you practice any kind, you go to the church, you go to the temple, nobody bother, really. But as soon as you connect with the real power, the king of Maya, the king of devil, begin to irritate you, to want to chase you, persecute you, make trouble for you, test your faith and endurance. That's the problem. So you see, what's left from the the real teaching is just a piece of cloth or a piece of tapish, no. The carpet, piece of carpet. What you use now become holy in 2,000 years to come. Later on, whoever belong to Qinghaiism and don't have a seat cushion like you, he is an atheist. You understand now? What the carpet means to some of the people? It's just a cushion that is such a necessity of the time. When the master is still alive, you do it, you take it with you because you need it. You know, like I sit here right now, there's nothing here. And it hurts. It hurts me. You know what I mean? So of course you take the carpet with you. You want to see? Okay, but it's good. It was very good for meditation. For example, okay, so of course, because the floor is hard, and especially in the old time, you can only sit on the floor, yeah, anywhere. So you take the carpet with you, just like you take the cushion with you, so you can sit longer and cleaner and warm and more stable. And that's all that is. And now, anybody who don't have a carpet is not a Muslim. For example, you know what I mean? And the carpet is everything to them. Nobody can touch it, for example. It becomes the holy thing instead of the object. It becomes a goal instead of just a mean to an end. It becomes an end. The carpet, people worship the carpet, for example. And another thing, Jews, they have the prayer shawl. Prayer shawl, you call it? Yes. Okay, that is everything to them. They even use it to exorcist or to cure people, and they believe in that. It's just a piece of cloth that we call Guanyin cloth at the moment. You know what I mean? But now, everything left from Judaism is a cloth. Or the top of the head, the symbolic, you know, of the head. Because in all the time, the men must also wear something to cover themselves. But it looks bad, you know? Or this people can... they fear that people know them, so they use some symbolic, you know, they wear a little head here, see? And now everything, anything else left, just the head, the little head here, a little for the Jews. Or the prayer shawl, shawl, yeah. The prayer shawl, we do have now, but nobody even talk about it. But for them, it's holy, it's sacred, it's God. How can you use a shawl to exercise, you know, devil out of people? But they do that. Of course it doesn't work. So you know what, everything now, What happened to all the religion? That's why I told you, all the religion are correct, came from the same source. But now what's left is only the ritual and rite and rituals and regulations, yeah? And some signal, secret signal, nothing more. Otherwise, all religions came from the same Guan Yin method. That's the only method that create all religion. That's the only method that all the master in the past, present, and future teach. That's the only source of all religion of mankind. You understand now? Got it? Okay. So don't ask me any path or the path. There's no path at all. It's only one direct connection. And if we know it, we know it. If we don't, we don't. Even if you sit for 1,000 years and your bottom fall off, it doesn't make any difference. You don't connect. When there's no electricity, you plug in there 1,000 years, the light doesn't come out. Nothing functions. I hope you do understand. Of course, some of you do. And I wish you will understand very soon and truly appreciate what you have got. Otherwise, it's really, really a greatest loss in your great journey to the kingdom of God. There's one chance in a lifetime, in many lifetimes. That's why you don't appreciate it. Because in the old time, you don't get it like this. You don't just come in and knock at the door and then you get it. You are chased by government, by police, by enemies, by all kinds of religious fanatics before you even see the master in person, if you ever will. And if you ever believe in that master as well. And after that, if you ever stay, you know, and never waver on the path. Look at what happened to Peter, to Judah. Huh? Peter, the greatest disciple. People ask him, do you know this person? No, no. I don't know him. I don't know what Jesus is. See what I mean? The great disciple. Master Jesus personally trained them many years. Day and night they sleep together, eat together. All kind of secret teaching imparted to them. Look at what happened to them. At the time of a crucial emergency, he doesn't recognize the master. He doesn't want to. Because he fear for this ephemeral flesh. He fear that people kill him, laugh at him, punish him, torture his body. You see how much it takes to have faith? How long does the master take to train a disciple? And he, Peter, is a pillar of Christianity. Without him, no Catholicism exists, no Christianity ever come to our ear today. You know? You understand? See, even then, even the master trained himself and be so humble as Jesus. It's not that easy. Such a great soul as Peter, tested once and failed. Second time, failed again. Third time, he came and cried. Who else wouldn't cry? Yeah? See, in such a state, degrading state of our soul, we would even die. If you could see the degrading state of your soul, you would die. But there is still hope. We can make it together. We can try. If there is a little sincerity, the master will always stand by and help. As long as we walk just one step, the master power will come running. That's evident to you. Otherwise, I don't think. If there is not a master power within me who works, I don't think any woman at my age would be so crazy running around the world, spending her youth, time, money, energy, in order to get what? You know what I mean? if really has not been for master power, nothing else that worked this way. Do you think, or do you think it will work that way? You think any woman would do that? Or any man would do that? No, huh? No, I don't think so. It's too unordinary for any people to do that. You might can do it for a while with a certain few good friends, but not all kind of strangers, all kind of mentality, all kind of personality, all kind of nationalities, all kind of garbage. Anyhow, that's why I tell you, there is a master power that works. That master power convinced me. So, in any case, in these days, because we are in a very difficult time of our planet, so God has been very generous and easy. So we, also there is a law of this time that no master would be killed anymore. Maybe if tortured inside, tortured inside mentally, but not killed. So it's easier to spread the Dharma, to spread the teaching openly, every nation, every country, because the master will not be harmed physically anymore. So that's why it's easy. Anyone who takes this job as a master can travel around freely, but not always. I will tell you some story later. And that's why people get in touch with the God power in a very easy way. That's why it looks cheap to some of you. That's why you don't understand. That's why you don't appreciate it. Because you're so used to it, sweating yourself or shedding your blood in order to earn a piece of bread. You can't believe anything so good, precious, noble, so free, and unconditional. But that's where you make mistake. So you better be careful. I'm not telling you because I don't know anything else better to tell you. I have studied many methods as well. I have many teachers, not only this life, but many lives. So I tell you from my own knowledge and experience. If there is something else better, I would have gone and studied. I will not deprive myself of any higher knowledge and wasting my time sitting here and talking nonsense to you. Because I'm the one who likes to pursue the truth myself. You understand? For me, even if you feel detached to this world, I feel the same too. See, all I want is God. Everything else just come by the way. Because I want God so much, so everything else will come. You think I would like all this kind of thing? Nah, not really. I just wear it for fun, just to make you feel more colorful so you can remember me better in your meditation. Because you're still in this world, you still love a little outer beauty. That's all right with me. As soon as I come home, oh, I can't wait to take it off. I never wear them before even before I got married. Or after I got married, why would I wear them now? You know what I mean? I didn't even care about them before enlightenment. Why should I care about them now? Just that whatever God tells me to do, whatever good for you, I do it. I even kill myself for you, so what is the little thing here that I could not do? You know what I mean? That's all. Because even you just meditate for a few hours, a few days, you still don't feel like putting too much of this thing anymore. How much would I even feel now? I don't want it. But never mind, it's okay. Doesn't matter. It's the same job. Same job. When you cultivate a garden, if you plant some roses, or you plant chrysanthemum, or you plant a little more other kind of wild grass, it's also okay. It must not always be the roses. I want to tell you something, I forgot. What was it? Oh, yes. I told you that every country is free now, right? There's a law, there's a decree from heaven that there no master should be killed. The true master should not be killed this time. I hope. But still, there are a lot of obstacles. It's not as free as we think. We were thinking maybe in Jesus' time, yeah, it's a little bit difficult. People will persecute true practitioners. Or in Buddha's time, people would try to assassinate him because he was preaching the truth. But there is still the same thing happening now. Even though less obvious or less brutal or less visible to you. I know one master. He's a real master. He also teaches Kuan Yin method. He's an Indian, India. Now, he's not allowed to come to Germany anymore. And he did nothing wrong, for what I know. I can see. I know he's a very good person. If not talking about master, he's a very clear person. He doesn't take money, he doesn't demand anything from disciples. He just teach. He's a true master. Yeah? Not talking about his level, okay? Maybe I cannot see his level, but he teach Kuan Yin method as well. There are several teachers who teach this. And he was a really, really good soul, noble one. Maybe I cannot guarantee to you his level of practice, but I can guarantee you his character, his personality, his heart is a very good man, okay? So put it that way, so you it's more practical to you. I cannot prove to you the thing I cannot put it out, so I can only tell you he's a very good man, okay? But for my own knowledge, he's also a very noble, elevated, high-level practitioner. Okay. What he has done? Nothing. One time, the German disciples requested him to make also a retreat for the children in somewhere, I forgot. I only heard, I don't know anything about it, but what I heard is true. And then so he okay. Maybe 4 days or 7 days retreat. And that's the only crime that he did. Now they forbid him to go to Germany because he made that retreat for the children. And other family members who don't agree with this policy, they come out, they went and, persecuted him. Yeah. They reported to the authority that he abused the children. Make the crime from nothing. And you know what it's like. In Western, your Western country, like America or Europe, if you abuse children, you're finished. Luckily, he's Indian. Otherwise, he'd be sitting in jail now in Germany and praying to God over there. So now he's not allowed to go to Germany anymore because of that, because he was too good to children, because he accepted the request from his disciples to take care of their children for these certain days. According to their wish. You see that? For no crime at all, he has been persecuted. And it was on the papers and television and all that as well. So even though they did not kill the master, or he's not allowed to kill a master anymore, it's not that easy. All right? I just want to let you know that you should appreciate your chance. Otherwise, no one can help you. Even God come down here right now, if you don't accept, God cannot do anything. Because we all have free will. We all have the right to accept or refuse anything, even from God. That's why He is God. That's why there is universe. That's why there is cosmos and many other things, etc., etc. You understand? This is 1995, 2,000 years after Jesus. These things still happen. I can swear to you, I can swear on God's name that that man is innocent. I have nothing to do with him, I get nothing from him. You know? And I don't have to know him, you don't have to know him. We have nothing to do with us. But that man is innocent, 100%, 1,000%. He has done nothing wrong. You know that, right? If we do retreat together and if the children are there, what can I do? Or what can anyone do with the children? The families are there, the members are there. All they do is sit in a room with the parents perhaps, yeah, and the teacher were there and sit with them for a while. You don't have to sit with them all the time. Just like I'm with you. I sit with you for a while, and perhaps I go do something else, and you continue your sitting, and I'm around, right? I don't have to sit with you all day long. What can I do with you here now, in this room, for example? But even in Taiwan before, when we retreat, we don't let other outside people come in. Huh? Then many people also say something nasty about us. Say we are taking all our clothes off and doing something here, inside. You see that? We even have to cover ourselves, talking about taking clothes off. Thing like that, you know what I mean? That's why I know that man is innocent. 1,000, 1,000,000, 1,000,000,000% innocent. He's done nothing wrong. He's an old man, very dedicated to God and to his disciples. I haven't seen anyone who's more dedicated. I feel very sorry for him. Now he said in India, I heard, sick with karma. And no one can understand him. He's sick, his both lungs full of water. I don't know when he will die. And there's nothing anyone can do for him. It's not only the physical burden he has to bear. It's a bad name. It's a blackened reputation that he has to even bear during the time that he lived. It's like he's dying while living, you know? Jesus, he died only once and quickly on the cross. But the today master, even though they don't die, but they die inside. So I'm lucky to still be able to sit here with you. And I don't know for how long. I can never tell. So don't think I will always have time for you. So take care of yourself. Every minute is very important. You never know if I have the same fate or if something will happen and we never see each other again. Anything could happen. War, disasters, yeah? Atom bomb, anything. So don't think that I want anything from you or I want you to worship me. Or follow me, or listen to me for the sake of my ego. No, no, no. I worry for you. Because you never know if you see me again, never mind worshiping me, following me, or do anything for me. I don't need anything. When you look at me closely, when you see the thing I do, you know that I'm not the one for fame and name and money and things like that. Don't you? Do you? You look closely and you see the thing I do, then you know. So all the thing is for you. And don't think because I can travel freely now, I might be able to do so the rest of my life. May not be so. Look at that man. He's famous before I'm born. His teacher and his whole lineage, the whole clan, is famous before my parents even born. They have disciples all over the world. And what happened to him? And he's a real master from India. Never mind me, just born a few decades ago and nobody even know my name, and from Vietnam and refugees and all that. You know what I mean? I have not even heavy weight. I have no background. I have no great lineage, no great famous master backing me. I have nothing. I'm born in Vietnam. When people think of Vietnam, they want to run away. I have nothing to wait. I have nothing I can lean on to catch people or to support myself, to protect myself. Nothing. So anything could happen anytime. Not that because I'm free now to travel, that all the teaching are so easy to get. It's easy because I make it easy. It is easy because I know it's very difficult if I make it difficult. It's already difficult enough for you to come to me through all the obstacles and problem and karma and all that. And once you come here, I would like to keep you. I would like to help you because it's already difficult enough for you to arrive here, just that you don't know it. You don't know how much garbage the master has to clean before you arrive here. You know nothing. You're like a child taken care of by parents. It's all right. It's all right. But do not waste this opportunity, because you won't get it again for many thousand millions of years. If you waste once, you have to be on the last of the waiting list if you want to begin again. Just like in a shop, huh? You see something you want to buy, but you didn't. Or you pay money for something, or you went out. And when later, when you regret, you want to come back in and buy. If people are already in front of you a lot, and you have to wait in the last queue, at the last queue, because all the people are already in front of you. To be a human being is already very, very, very difficult. And in order to meet a real master and get initiated into this Kuan Yin method, I cannot tell you. I have no human language to describe to you the precious of this method. I have no ability to tell you. I really cannot. To compare to anything at all, it means you blacken the name of the method. This is no comparison. There's nothing you can say about it. All you have to do is open your heart, humble yourself, and then you will see how it works for you every day. Do not deprive yourself from this most mighty power. Let it work for you. Just let it work for you. Relax. Let it be. Then everything you want will come. Every protection will be yours. Every day will be a miracle. I suffer because of you. Otherwise, I'm the most happy person in the world. I never know suffering after initiation until I met you. So don't look at me and think because I meditate, I still suffer. No, no. It's all yours. It's all your karma. The years before I take over this job, I don't know what misery and unhappiness or discontentment. I have 3-4 pairs of clothes. I'm every day happy as an angel. I have nothing with me. I'm just happy. There's indescribable inside. Because I was having no responsibility for anybody. I don't know what suffering and unhappiness was. It's too late now to come back to that stage. But it's all right, as long as you know what you're getting and open yourself to this power and let it help you. Otherwise, it's a waste of your time and my time too. And you will regret it later, and it's too late. When you are sent back to this transmigration again, then you can see it from heaven, how you're going to suffer. At that time, you regret. This is very, very late. Oh, okay. I was telling you how to meditate on Kuan Yin, and I talked so long. Now you can meditate. Meditate until 10, right? Meditate.